Hello everyone, I am going to solve reading passage 3. I have taken it from reading from test 2 and the book is IELTS Cambridge 11. Now you should spend about 20 minutes on questions 27 to 40 which are based on reading passage 3 below. Okay. Now topic, always read the topic of the passage first, neuroaesthetics. Okay. Now look at the questions before reading the whole passage. Look at the question. These are the MCQ questions, multiple choice questions. Choose the correct letter A, B, C or D. Write the correct letter in boxes 27 to 30 on your answer sheet. Okay, up to 30, these are MCQs. And another part of the questions are, and these are, and now after this, we have questions 31 to 33. Complete the summary using the list of words. We are having help box for completing the sentences. After that, we have questions 34 to 39. Yes, this is for yes, no or not given. Just remember one thing. If they have given yes, no or not given, you have to use yes, no or not given. Not true, false and not given. Okay, the last question of this passage is again MCQ. Choose the correct letter A, B, C or D. This is only one question here, 40. Okay, let's start the question number one. Okay, 27 it's actually. Write the correct letter in boxes 27 to 30 on your answer sheet. 27. In the second paragraph, the writer refers to a shape matching test in order to illustrate. In the second paragraph, the writer is saying go to the second paragraph and find the answer. The writer refers to a shape matching test in order to illustrate, for examples. So you will be looking for the word shape matching test and in the second paragraph directly. Could the same approach also shed light on abstract 20th century pieces from Mondrian's geometrical blocks of color and to Pollock's seemingly haphazard arrangements of splashed paint on canvas? Okay, we'll directly look for the word match. What was the shape matching test? Okay. We certainly do have an inclination to follow the crowd when asked to make simple perceptual decisions such as matching a shape to its rotated image. For example, people often choose matching a shape. Definitely choose a definitely wrong answer if they see others doing the same. It is easy to imagine that this mentality would have even more impact on fuzzy concept like art appreciation where there is no right or wrong answer. Okay, now what the question is saying, again look at the question. The writer refers to a shape matching test in order to show something. When asked to make simple perceptual decisions such as matching a shape to its rotated image, when, for example, people often choose a definitely wrong answer if they see others doing the same. Okay, just look at the questions and the options again. The subjective nature of art appreciation? No. The reliance of modern art on abstract forms? No, I don't think so. This is the option. C. Our tendency to be influenced by the opinions of others? Yes. Here the writer is saying, People often choose a definitely wrong answer if they see others doing the same answer. They want to be different in the crowd. Okay. See, so answer is our tendency to be influenced by the people of others. So we will select this C. Again, we can read this. We certainly do have inclination to follow the crowd. This is also a keyword for this option we have chosen. Our tendency to be influenced by the opinions of others. Now move on to the next question. Angela Hawley Dolan's finding indicate that people he is telling about. Angela's finding indicate that people. Now where is Angela? Angelina Hawley Dolan of Boston College responded to this debate by asking volunteers to view pairs of painting, either the creations of famous abstract artists or the doodles of infants, chimps and elephants. Again read the question. Findings indicate that people, okay, directly go to the results, findings, then they had to judge which they preferred. A third of the paintings were given no captions. While many were labeled incorrectly, volunteers might think they were viewing a chimp's massive brush strokes when they were actually seeing an acclaimed masterpiece. In each set of trials, volunteers generally preferred the work of renowned artist, even when they believe it was by an animal or child. It seems that the viewer can sense the artist's vision in paintings even if they can't explain why. In this line we can get the answer here. It seems that the viewer can sense the artist's vision in paintings even if they can't explain why. Here the options are: mostly favor works of art which they know well. No. Hold fixed ideas about which makes a good work of art. No. Are often misled by their initial expectation of a work of art. I don't think so. Have the ability to perceive the intention behind works of art. Yes, this is the correct option. And how we have proved this? Here. From here we can say, in each set of trials, volunteers generally preferred the work of renowned artists even when they believe it was by an animal or a child. It seems that the viewer can sense the artist's vision in painting. Can sense. Have the ability to perceive the intention behind works of art, even if they can't explain why. So they have used the word, different synonym word for this, ability to perceive. A viewer can sense the artist's vision in painting. They have the ability to perceive the intention behind works of art. Intention here means can sense the artist's vision in painting even if they can't explain why. Okay. Now move on to question 29. Results of studies involving Robert Pepperell's pieces suggest that people. Now results involving Robert Pepperell's pieces, okay, suggest that people. Again we look for the Robert, the okay, here is Robert Pepperell, an artist based at Cardiff University, creates ambiguous works that are neither entirely abstract nor clearly representational. In one study, Pepperell and his collaborators asked volunteers to decide how powerful they considered an artwork to be and whether they saw anything familiar in the piece. Okay. The longer they took to answer these questions, the more highly they rated the piece under scrutiny and the greater their neural activity. It would seem, okay. Again, it would seem here in the previous paragraph, here was the answer. It seems. It means this is the result, the findings, that the brain sees these images as puzzles. These images here, he is describing the pieces. And the harder it is to decipher the meaning, the more rewarding is the moment of recognition. Okay, what are the options here? First, we'll read the question again. Results of studies. Pieces suggest that people can appreciate a painting. Can appreciate a painting without fully understanding it? No. Find it satisfying to work out what a painting represents. Okay. Just we'll take a look at the paragraph again. Vary widely in the time they spend looking at paintings. Generally prefer representational art to abstract art. Okay. जस्ट रीड द पैराग्राफ अगेन. द लोंगर दे टुक टू आंसर दीज क्वेश्चंस द मोर हाईली दे रेटेड द पीस अंडर स्क्रूटिनी एंड द ग्रेटर देयर न्यूरल एक्टिविटी. इट वुड सीम डैट द ब्रेन सीज दीज इमेजेस दीज पीसेज. दे हैव टोल्ड रॉबर्ट्स पीसेज सजेस्ट दैट पीपल एज पजल्स एंड द हार्डर इट इज टू डेसिफर द मीनिंग द मोर रिवॉर्डिंग इज द मोमेंट ऑफ रिकॉग्नाइजेशन. ओके नाउ वील लुक फॉर द नो इट वॉज it is wrong. I can appreciate a painting without fully understanding it. They have not given it. Find it satisfying to work out what a painting represents. Whenever they are doing, the brain sees these images as puzzle. These pieces of Robert, artist piece of Robert, they see these images as puzzles. And the harder it is to decipher the meaning and the more rewarding is the moment of recognition. So option is B. Find it satisfying to work out what a painting represents. Very widely in the time they spend looking at paintings, no. Generally prefer representational art to abstract art, no. So moving to question 30. What do the experiments described in the fifth paragraph? What do the experiments, okay, described in the fifth paragraph suggest about the paintings of Mondrian? Paintings of Mondrian suggestion. Now in this question, the writer is not asking about the people. In all these questions, they were asking about people. Now he is asking suggestions. They are asking about the paintings of Mondrian. Okay, we'll look for the, okay, till here there was no word Mondrian. Move on to the next paragraph, next page. And what about artists such as Mondrian, whose paintings consist exclusively of horizontal and vertical lines encasing blocks of color? Okay, now he is explaining paintings. Mondrian's works are deceptively simple, but eye-tracking studies confirm they are meticulously composed and that simply rotating a piece radically changes the way we view it. Now these are the features of Mondrian's painting. We will just look at the options again about the paintings of Mondrian. They are more carefully put together than they appear. Yes, this is the sentence they are saying here. Mondrian's work are deceptively simple here, okay, but eye tracking studies confirm that they are meticulously composed and that simply rotating a piece. Okay, they are more carefully put together then they appear. Okay, for this A is the correct answer. They move on to next options also. They can be interpreted in number of different ways. They have not given this. They challenge our assumptions about shape and color. No, they are easier to appreciate than many other abstract work. No. Okay, now come to the another part of questions. Now this is questions 31 to 33. Complete the summary using the list of words A to H below. Write the correct letters A to H in boxes 31 to 33 on your answer sheet. Okay, art and the brain, the discipline of neuro. Okay, before reading the this passage, we will go to the help box. In first, A is interpretation, complexity, emotions, movement, skill, layout, concern, images. See, there is a tip in this. If you are like you are having shortage of time in your examination, then you may not need to read the whole paragraph. You may choose the words according to the sentence which fit in your fill in the blanks. Like I'll try to do it with the help of help box only, without reading the paragraphs. The discipline of neuroaesthetics aims to bring scientific objectivity to the study of art. Neurological studies of the brain, for example, demonstrate the impact which impressionist paintings have on our studies. So for example, okay, what it will fit in on our, what is our relation to human being, interpretation no, complexity no, emotions, this may be possible to fit in this blank. Movements have on our paintings impression, demonstrate the impact which impressionist paintings have on our, I think, skill, layout, concern, images. I think emotion should come here. Sorry, C. No proper word, only the alphabets will come in the blanks. C will come. Alex Forsyth of the University of Liverpool believes many artists give their works the precise degree of dash. Give their works the precise degree of dash which most appeals to the viewer's brain. Okay, interpretation, degree of dash, what? Movements, concern, complexity, skill, images, emotions, layout. Okay, for this we will be concerning the paragraph which most appeals to the viewer's brain. She also observes that pleasing work of art often contains certain repeated dash which occur frequently in the natural world. She also observes that pleasing works of art often contain certain repeated which occur frequently in the natural. Interpretation, no, movements, no, concern, complexity, skill, images. Yes. Works of art often contain certain repeated images. Yes, I got this. Which occur frequently in the natural world. This is H. Definitely it would be H answer. We will be matching it in the paragraph also. Okay, for this we may put some guess also. Give their works the precise degree of dash. Alex of the University of Liverpool believes that many artists give their works the precise degree of. Okay, let's look at the paragraph for this answer. Okay, first we will look for the keywords, the discipline of, okay, needed to bring scientific objective to the study of art. Okay, we were here. Okay, I think we have left first paragraph also. Okay, and okay, huh? Okay, yes, we got an emerging discipline word we were looking for. Discipline called neuroaesthetics is seeking to bring scientific objectivity to the study of art and has already given us a better understanding of many masterpieces. The blurred imagery of impressionist paintings seems to stimulate the brain's amygdala, for instance, since the amygdala plays a crucial role in our feelings. Let's read the paragraph again. The discipline of neuroaesthetic aims to bring scientific objectivity to the study of art. Neurological studies of the brain, for example, demonstrate the impact which, okay, painting. Already till here we have got the blurred imagery of impressionist paintings seem to stimulate the brains. Okay, since the amygdala plays a crucial role in our feelings, that finding might explain why many people find these pieces so moving. Okay, studies of the brain, for example, demonstrate the impact which impressionist painting have on our emotions. There they have used the word feelings. In these kinds of fill in the blanks, you are not getting direct answers. You have to do the paraphrased of that used word in the paragraph and match it with these lines in the from the help box. You have to get paraphrase your words. Further on, Alex, okay fine, we got the word. And in another experiment, Alex of the University of Liverpool analyzed the visual intricacy of different pieces of art, and her results suggest that many artists use a key level of detail to please the brain. Alex of the believes that many artists give their work the precise degree of. We have to look for the degree word, degree. डिटेल टू लिटल एंड वर्क इज बोरिंग बट टू मच रिजल्ट्स इन ए काइंड ऑफ ओवरलोड पीसेस. ओके रीड लेट्स रीड अगेन. एलेक्स ऑफ द यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ लिवरपूल एनालाइज द विजुअल इंट्रिकेसी ऑफ डिफरेंट पीसेज ऑफ आर्ट. ओके गिव देयर वर्क्स अ प्रिसाइज डिग्री ऑफ डैश विच मोस्ट अपील टू द व्यूअर्स ब्रेन. ओके नाउ ही इज सेइंग एनालाइज द विजुअल इंट्रिकेसी ऑफ डिफरेंट पीसेज ऑफ आर्ट एंड हर रिजल्ट्स. नाउ ही इज सेइंग डिफरेंट वर्क्स द देयर वर्क्स द प्रिसाइज डिग्री ऑफ the precise degree of complexity. Intricacy here means complexity of different pieces of art. Analyze the visual intricacy of different pieces of art and her results suggest that many artists use a key level of detail to please the brain. Key level of detail, they have done it very minutely. Many artists give their work the precise degree of dash complexity. So here answer will come here B only, which most appeal to the viewer's brain. So let's read the paragraph lines again. Analyzed the visual intricacy of different pieces of art and her results suggest that many artists use a key level of detail to please the brain. Most appeals to the viewer's brain. Move on to next sentence. She also observes that pleasing works of art often contain certain repeated dash which occur frequently in the natural world. Okay, we put here answer H. So just verify our answer. Okay, she also pleasing work of art. Appealing pieces, both abstract and show signs of fractals, repeated motifs recurring in different scales. Fractals are common throughout the nature. Okay, visual here. Too little and the work is boring, but too much results in a kind of perceptual overload. According to Forsyth, what's more appealing pieces, both abstract and representational, show signs of fractals. Fractals, repeated motif recurring in different scales. Fractals, they are talking about fractals. She also observes that pleasing work of art often contains certain repeated images which occur frequently in the natural world. Okay. Now we have left with true, false and the last multiple choice question, MCQ question. Now, true, false, but here yes, no and not given. These kinds of mistake mostly students did in IELTS exam. That's why they got less bands. So in boxes 34 to 37 on your answer sheet, write yes, no, not given. Yes, if the statement agrees. No, if the statement contradicts. Not given if there is no information on this. Forsyth's finding contradicted previous beliefs on belief on the function of fractal in art. Okay, we look for this name. Okay, in another experiment, Alex of the University of Liverpool analyzed the visual intricacy of different pieces of art, and we have already done this. Too little and work is boring. Okay, fractals, he believes on the function of fractals in art. Here they have written fractals in art. Fractals are commonly throughout nature, fractals here also. For example, in the shapes of mountain peaks or the branches of trees, it is possible that our visual system, which evolved in the great outdoors, find it easier to process such patterns. So again, read the sentence. Forsyth's findings contradicted. Just focus on this word. Previous beliefs on the function of fractals in art. I don't find any contradiction statement given by Forsyth. So I think this is not given statement. Not given. Again, I am writing in capital letter because in the instruction, in the direction, they had given in capital letters. 35. Certain ideas regarding the link between mirror neurons and art appreciations require further verification. Certain ideas, okay, regarding the link between mirror, we will look for these two words, art appreciation and mirror neurons, require further verification. Just focus on further verification also. Further verification, they may be given, but whether they have given the information about further verification, then it will be true. Okay, mirror neurons. We'll look for the word mirror neurons for this. Since this is passage 3, this is the longest and difficult passage in the reading. Neurons, where they have given, yes, here I got the word mirror neurons. Okay, this has led some to wonder whether Pollock's works feel so dynamic because the brain reconstructs the energetic actions the artist used as he painted. This may be down to our brain's mirror neurons, which are known to mimic other section. The hypothesis, yes, will need to be thoroughly tested. Hypothesis here means they are verifying it. They are doing inquiry. Will be need to thoroughly tested there, which however it might even be the case that we could use neuroaesthetic studies to understand the longevity. Some pieces of artwork. The hypothesis will need to be thoroughly tested. However, it might even be the case that we could use neuroaesthetic studies to understand the longevity of some pieces of artwork. Now, they have clearly given certain ideas. Yes, they were saying regarding the link between mirror neurons and art appreciation require further verification. Further verification is important word. We have find it. The hypothesis will need to be thoroughly tested. Okay, so this is, yes, not true. Move on to question 36. People's taste in paintings depends entirely on the current artistic trends of the period. Okay, let's find people's taste in painting. We may not find the word proper taste in paintings, but we may find current artistic trends of the period. Okay. Till here we have already gone through. While the fashions of the time might shape what is currently popular, works that are best adapted to our visual system that may not be most likely to linger once the trends of previous generation have been forgotten. Okay, let's read the statement again. People's taste in paintings depends entirely on the current artistic trends. Okay, they in the paragraph they were talking about fashion of that period. So while the fashions of the time might shape what is currently popular, works that are best adapted to our visual system may be the most likely to linger once the trends of previous generations have been forgotten. So this is yes, no. I mean, yes, I got for that. Otherwise, sorry. I was doing 36 question. No. So answer is no. People's taste in finding depends entirely on the current artistic trends of the period. This is wrong. This is no. Answer is no. Might shape what is currently popular, that are best adapted to our visual system, may be the most likely to linger once the trends of the previous generation have been forgotten. Okay. Now, okay, G. 37. Scientists should seek to define the precise rules scientists should seek to define the precise rules which govern people's reaction to works of art. Scientists should seek to define, okay, just look at this important word, should seek to define the precise rules which govern people's reaction to works of art. Okay. Till it's now move on to last paragraph. It's still early days for the fields of neuroaesthetics, and these studies are probably only a taste of what is to come. It would, however, be foolish to reduce art appreciation to a set of scientific laws. Now, coming to the point, it would, however, be foolish to reduce art appreciation to a set of scientific laws. It would, however, be foolish to reduce art appreciation. So it is not good thing to reduce art appreciation for the sake of scientific laws. So here, scientists should seek to define the precise rules which governs people's reaction to works of art. Here he is saying it would, however, be foolish. So answer is no and no, no. Now, 38. Art appreciation should always involve taking into consideration, involve taking into consideration the cultural context in which an artist worked. Art appreciation should always involve taking into consideration, okay, the cultural context in which an artist worked. Now, we have done here. We shouldn't underestimate the importance of the style of a particular artist. Okay. The importance of the style of a particular artist, their place in history, and the artistic environment of their time. We got the statement here. Let's match it. Art appreciation should always involve taking into consideration the cultural context in which an artist worked. Okay, so this is yes, this is perfectly matching. They've given it directly. We shouldn't underestimate the importance of the style of a particular artist, their place in history, and the artistic environment of their time. For this, they have used importance of cultural context in which an artist worked. Cultural context here means their place in history and the artistic environment of their time. Okay, so this is last but not the least question. It is easier to find meaning in the field of science than in that of art. Okay, it is easier to find, easier. Now, in this question, he is comparing between two things. It is easier to find meaning in the field of science than in that of art. Now, in this question, he is comparing. 95% questions are not given when there is a comparison between two things. So we'll look for the statement, easier to find meaning in the field of science and that in of art. So we have left only two lines in the paragraph. In some ways, okay, abstract art offers both a challenge and the freedom to play with different interpretations. In some ways, it is not so different to science. Okay, where we are constantly looking for system and decoding meaning. Constantly looking for systems and decoding meaning, taking out the meaning so that we can view and appreciate the world in a new way. Okay, again, read the sentence. Abstract art offers both a challenge. Now, what is the statement? It is easier to find meaning in the field of science than in that of art. Now, he is putting the field of science on the upper side and he is ignoring the word art. But here the paragraph says, abstract art offers both a challenge and the freedom to play with different interpretations. In some ways, it is not so different to science. Where we are constantly looking for systems and decoding meanings so that we can view and appreciate the world in a new way. So this is not given actually. They are not comparing it. Okay. Now question 40. Choose the correct letter A, B, C or D. Write the correct letter in box 40 on your answer sheet. 40. What would be the most appropriate subtitle for the article? Till now we have read about some scientific insights into how the brain responds to abstract art. Okay. I think A must be the answer. Recent studies focusing on the neural activity of abstract artists. A comparison of the neurological basis of abstract and representational art. How brain research has altered public opinion about abstract art. I think A must be the proper answer. Some scientific insights into how the brain responds to abstract art. And the topic is related to neuroaesthetics, is related to brain only, study of brain. Okay, thank you so much. In this way, we have completed this match, this reading passage 3.